October is quickly wrapping up, which means November is right around the corner, which means Thanksgiving and turkey and stuffing and pumpkin pie, but it also means new Nintendo Switch games are coming out. And admittedly, it's kind of a dry month. Like, what the hell is actually coming out in the month of November? September was huge for the system, October as well, but November is admittedly a bit drier, but there's still some games coming out that I want to talk about. And I want to give you guys some more like challenges, because you just keep running through these like challenges, and now I have to dress up as Beetlejuice and play Ring Fit Adventure. I have to play some weird game where you're like a naked fireman in a Japanese village. So we're gonna put some more like challenges in this video, because there are some games that I feel like you'll want me to play, but I really don't want to play. So what the hell is coming out in the month of November for the Switch? Let's talk about it in this video. Sit back, relax, make sure you subscribe to the channel, and let's talk about the games for Nintendo Switch in the month of November. Rev your engines on November 1st, because Ryan is racing into your house with Race with Ryan, a kart-based racer on some YouTube kid who plays with toys. We're not talking about Race with Ryan on this channel. There is a superior kart racer coming out in the month of November anyways. But yeah, if you like the Ryan channel, you guess, you know, Race with Ryan, November 1st. Yay. Next up, do you like dancing? Do you like crappy music? Well, on November 5th, Just Dance 2020 will be dancing its way into your household. And yeah, I've never played a Just Dance game because, I don't know, it just doesn't kind of interest me. But there are 40 new songs in this game if you want to hear the stuff you hear on your radio and then play it in your house. There's 8 kids-related songs in here, so you can play with the whole family if you want to. And yeah, you dance to songs, you put the Joy-Cons in your hand, and you have a good time. I don't know, it's obviously a very popular series, but one that I've never played and never had a desire to play. But since you guys like to torture me, 3,500 likes on this video within 24 hours and I will buy and review and play Just Dance. So yes, you could see my dance moves in this game if you really want to see it. Just Dance 2020, November 5th. I hope I don't have to buy it, but maybe you'll make me. Next up, we finally have a game that I'm actually really looking forward to playing, and that is Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games Tokyo 2020. This game will be coming out on November 5th, and everything I've seen from this game looks very, very fun to me. There's a whole range of events ranging from your standard track and field stuff to surfing, karate, and even skateboarding. Yes, Yoshi on a skateboard. I'm really interested to see how the skateboarding segments work. I love skateboarding. I skateboarded for many years. I still have a skateboard. I like to ride it from time to time, so I'm really looking forward to this game. I think it looks really fun. The graphical style of the game is really nice as well. And of course, there's these 2D events that you can play in the game. There's actually 10 2D style events that you play in Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games Tokyo 2020 that actually use 2D sprites as well. So I think that looks really cool. It definitely has a very nice retro aesthetic. There's online play. There's a whole cast of characters that you can choose from both the Mario and the Sonic universes. I think this game is going to be a sleeper hit for the month of November. It's admittedly my second most anticipated game for the month of November as well, and I think it's going to be a lot of fun. As long as the events themselves are executed well and the online play is good, this could end up being, like I said, the sleeper hit for the month of November. Definitely a game I'm looking forward to playing, and definitely a game I'm very hyped about, and it comes out on November 5th. Do you like Disney? Do you like Tsum Tsum? Evidently, a lot of people like Tsum Tsum because Disney's Tsum Tsum is coming to the Nintendo Switch on November 8th, and I don't know what the hell this game is. Like, you collect these little puffy figures that are supposed to be based on Disney, but they really don't look like Disney characters, and you play in a host of mini-games. It's very popular in Japan. I saw a Tsum Tsum cartoon on the Disney Channel that had like 10 million views on it, so evidently there are people that like this out there. For me personally, this is going to be a skip. I really don't understand this game. Looks just like a compilation of mini games that you can play with your friends in local multiplayer and online. So yeah, Disney Tsum Tsum November 8th, not for me, but maybe for you. And also on November 8th, we have another game that I'm looking forward to, and that is New Super Lucky's Tales. Now, this game originally came out as Super Lucky Tales on the Xbox One, a 3D collectathon platformer. And many people saw this game and said that that's a game that would do well on the Nintendo Switch. It's obviously a retro-inspired 3D collectathon, and it did okay on the Xbox One, but now they're bringing it to the Nintendo Switch with New Super Lucky's Tale, and they've actually included a whole bunch of new stuff in this game. There's new environments you play as. They've improved things like the artwork and the lighting and the voice samples in the game. They've improved the character control as well. So it looks like this is sort of the definitive edition of Super Lucky's Tales. Now, I never played the original game on the Xbox One, but I will be checking it out on the Nintendo Switch. This definitely seems like a game that is a good fit for the system. And while Super Lucky's Tales might not have the character charisma as something as you saw with Banjo-Kazooie and, of course, all the great 3D platformers, I think it's going to be a pretty solid game and a pretty fun game. It's definitely a game that's on my radar, and it comes out on November 8th. So will will you be picking up new Super Lucky's Tales? Let me know in the comment section down below. Do you like pro wrestling? Do you like RGT85? Well, check out the new merchandise in the merch store. We have some AEW-inspired RGT merchandise. We got shirts, hoodies. We even got hats now, which I'm very excited for. You got free shipping on October 25th as well. So depending on when you're watching this video, you can get free shipping on your order. Be sure to check it out. The link is in the description box down below. And as I alluded to, this is a two-part like challenge, and the second like challenge is going to be for Jumanji, which comes out on November 8th. Now, this is not based on the original movie or really based on the board game, I think. It's obviously based on the newer movie that starred Kevin Hart and, of course, The Rock. And really, I don't know what the hell's going on with this game. I watched the trailer. It seems like a compilation of weird mini-games that somehow resemble Jumanji. I don't really know. This game looks absolutely bizarre to me, and I do not want to play it because it's like $40. However, if you get 4,000 likes, yes, I'm really increasing these numbers because you guys are just running through it like it's nothing. 4,000 likes within 24 hours of me uploading this video. Not only will I do Just Dance 2020, but I will also do Jumanji because at my heart, I do love the original Jumanji movie. And I think the board game itself is actually a really neat thing. This game looks like absolute shovelware, but if you really want me to play it, you will do the like challenge on this. Jumanji comes out on November 8th and it's not great. The Nintendo Switch is obviously a JRPG machine, and a JRPG that was never localized for the West is finally coming over, and it's coming to the Nintendo Switch on November 11th, and that is Romancing Saga 3. Now, Romancing Saga 3 is a very popular franchise that was done by Squaresoft back in the day during the 16-bit era. Like I said, this game was never localized officially until now. They've improved the graphics with some new HD character stuff and some new sprite work going on. There's new environments to explore as well, so it seems like a really definitive edition of this game, and of course, like I said, it is the first time it has been localized in the West. If you're looking for a traditional JRPG experience, you're looking for something a bit classic, I think this game will really fill that void for you in the month of November. It looks like a really solid game, honestly. It seems like a lot of people are hyped for this as well, so I definitely wanted to mention that Romancing Saga 3 is finally coming to the West on November 11th. Next up, we have a game that admittedly I hadn't really heard of before, but it kind of has my interest, and that is Super Street Racer, which comes to the Nintendo Switch on November 12th. Now, you might remember back in the day, we got a lot of Need for Speed games, and the Underground series was very, very popular. And as time has gone on, of course, we sort of shifted away from that sort of gameplay style. The whole Fast and the Furious craze seems to have come to an end. But Super Street Racer actually looks like a spiritual successor to that Need for Speed Underground style. You buy cars, you build them up, you get boosts, and you do different things like street racing. It looks sort of arcadey, you know, more so than the traditional racing games that we've been seeing, but that sort of is what Need for Speed Underground was all about. There's some free roam areas where you can find different things. You can actually win girls in this game, which, wow, I'm sure Kotaku and Polygon are absolutely going to love that, but it's definitely sort of a throwback to that arcade style racing game. I hope Ja Rule is on the soundtrack because, you know, he was a big part of the Fast and the Furious series, and I feel like he's probably hurting a bit for money nowadays. So maybe we can get Ja on the soundtrack, but honestly, it looks like a decent racing game. I like these styles of games. I really enjoyed the Underground series back in the day, and I think a lot of people did. So as long as the gameplay is good in this game, this could end up being really fun. It has local multiplayer. It has 8-player online as well. So I think this could end up being a decent game. There is some weird pricing stuff going on with this game. Some retailers have it listed for $50. Some retailers have it listed for $40. I know GameStop and I believe Amazon have it listed for $40, but other places have it listed for $50 like Best Buy. So if you're interested in this game, you might want to pre-order it now when it's available for $40. And honestly, I probably will check out this game because I'm really curious about it when it comes out on the Nintendo Switch on November 12th. And of course, we have the big release of the month, the game that you probably think is my number one anticipated game for the month, but it's actually number three, yes, behind Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games, and that is Pokemon Sword and Shield. Now, I think Pokemon Sword and Shield looks fine. There has been so much controversy around this game, with people unhappy about the national decks, unhappy about the graphics of the game, but the game itself is going to sell well, let's be honest. It is the next iteration of Pokemon. I think the gigantic evolutions that you could do in the game look really cool. Pokemon Pokemon is a series that I'm not really heavily invested in. I'm more of a casual Pokemon player. I will play it from time to time and check it out. So it's not a huge deal that some of these features are missing, but I could definitely see why it has been a controversial topic. A lot of people have been going after Game Freak's ass on this game, and I could see why in some regards, but you gotta be respectful, people. But yes, the next iteration, the first home console mainline Pokemon game, is finally coming on November 15th with Pokemon Sword and Shield. Are you Team Sword or Team Shield? Let me know in the comments down below. So we've pretty much gone through all of the main games for the month of November. So what is the last game we have to talk about? Because obviously this game is my number one most anticipated game for the month of November. And you're gonna think I'm trolling you to some aspect, but I'm not. I'm actually really looking forward to this game, and you could go to hell if you disagree with me on that. And that is Garfield Kart Furious Racing, coming to us on November 19th. I am dead ass serious about this as well. As a kid, I loved Garfield and Friends. That was one of my favorite shows. I would dance on the bed to the theme song. Come on in, come to the place where fun never ends. Come on in, it's time to party with Garfield and Friends. Garfield and Friends. And Garfield Kart Furious Racing looks absolutely fantastic. It is a front runner for Game of the Year. You play as Garfield and some of his friends like Nurmal and John Arbuckle. There is no Binky the Clown. I'm kind of upset by that. Obviously, this is probably based on the more modern Garfield, but maybe we'll get Binky the Clown as DLC. And it's a kart racer, and it has Garfield, and Garfield is cool. There's online racing in this game as well, so I can destroy all of you in this game. I like the levels. I like the graphical style of the game. I am legitimately looking forward to this game. You need to put some respect on Jim Davis's name. Garfield is amazing. Garfield Kart Furious Racing is the potential front runner for Game of the Year 2019. It could actually overtake Mario Kart as well as the best kart racing game of all time. And yeah, I'm actually like dead ass serious. I'm going to buy this game on day one, and you can't stop me. You can't stop me. All right, so those are the upcoming Switch games for the month of November. Kind of a bit of a quiet month, but there are some games on here that I'm definitely looking forward to playing. So let me know in the comments section down below what games you're looking forward to playing. And as always, guys, be sure to hit that like button. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe. And you really have to like this so you can make me play Just Dance 2020 and Jumanji and do videos on them. And as always, guys, thank you for your constant support, and I will catch you guys on the next video. Later.